Hey guys, Kate Kennedy here with my first layout using the December Hip Kit. I want to give credit to fellow YouTuber Tuesday Hubbard for inspiring this layout. She made one where she cut paper strips and used a punch on them, and I just definitely got inspiration from her for this layout. So what I'm going to do is I've cut these strips to 3.5 by 12 inches, and I'm going to use this Martha Stewart. It's kind of a doily punch, and punch out each of these different pattern papers to get that nice edge on it. Now I decided to leave them the full 12 inches because I wasn't sure if I was going to put them the entire length of the layout or not. You'll see in a second that I do end up cutting them into 6-inch pieces, but that just makes it so I have 10 patterns to work with because both sides of the paper are so pretty. So here I'm just cutting them into 6-inch strips, and then I'm going to kind of fuss with this for a minute. I lay them all out one way, and then I end up doing it to where I have some patterns on the bottom and then some on the top. But I'm just going to kind of play a little bit of music while I figure this out because I don't really know what I was thinking when I was doing it. I was just fussing with it until I found a way that I thought it looked just right. So here I've kind of pulled some different embellishments, and I've decided to use this alphabet that we get in the kit from Pink Paisley, I believe. Yeah, it is so pretty. I love this alphabet. And my title isn't going to end up the way that it looks now. I'm just going to fuss around a little bit more, take everything off the layout, and kind of start back arranging things again. You know how these things happen. It evolves over messing with it for a little while. So I've gone ahead and put some foam adhesive on the back of my photograph, and now I'm just gluing these layers together. And the reason why I left them with such height on them is because I want to be able to glue them together and then have enough of the part that's not glued down to be able to kind of fluff it up a little bit to give it a little bit of texture or dimension. You can see that's what I'm doing here. And then this is when I decide that it needs something on the top. And I had those other layers just laying there, and I was like, well, I could just flip those around. And I ended up really liking the way that that looked. So that's what I did. And I believe I didn't even map my photograph because I thought that the pattern papers gave it enough behind it to work. So now I've just trimmed down the white cardstock, and I'm going to mat it on some gray cardstock that comes in the cardstock add-on, and then I'm just going to kind of pull up the edges a little bit so they're not so flat down on the cardstock. I'm going to use some dimensional adhesive pretty much for all of these embellishments. These are, I think all of them are from, well, yeah, that's the only embellishments that, they're the Amy Tangerine stitched line. And then y'all know my go-to title is down the side of the photograph. If I have a hard time and I didn't want to take away from all those beautiful layers of die-cut paper, So I just love the title going down the side, especially with this alphabet. And I love that it's not like a harsh black. They're really soft grays. And the colors are just perfect. Not to mention, this photograph is of my brother and his girlfriend. And it's at our wedding. And a lot of the colors, the mint and the gold and that kind of corally color, were our wedding color. So it was just perfect. It all went so nicely together. Now I'm just cutting up some of the stitched rub-ons, the Amy Tangerine stitched rub-ons, and they're little like X's. I'll have a close-up picture at the end. And I'm just kind of, the perimeter of the layout felt a little bit plain on the plain cardstock. If you matted this with pattern paper, it wouldn't have needed these rub-ons, I don't think. But I just thought it was a nice little touch of detail, and I really like the way that it turned out, because I was debating between whether or not to put ink on this layout, and I said, no, let me just use some rub-on. So that is what I did. I'm going to adhere this panel down and add some journaling and adhere my title. So I just used some multi-matte medium to adhere that title down, which is nice because it's going to dry clear. I'm taking my little distressing tool around the edge of this white cardstock just to give it a little bit more texture. And that's pretty much going to finish the layout. I'm going to add one little embellishment in the title. And I'm going to think I need more and kind of fuss around with some things. I'm going to pull a bunch of stuff out. I have like a pile next when I work with my hip kits of other hip kit products that came in past kits that I haven't used up yet, because I really, one of my goals for this year is to use up all of my like extra supplies and stuff. I make a lot of projects, but I get a lot of product. So, and I just don't, we're moving and I don't want to waste it. And I don't want to, I mean, I'm going to move it because I'm not going to throw it away, but I just want to get a lot of this stuff used up because it's so beautiful and I want to put it down on paper. Thanks guys so much for watching, and I will see you real soon. Bye.